following UW360 story is made possible by the generous support of BECU. BECU, more than just money.
Listen carefully to the relentless rise of carbon pollution in the Earth's atmosphere. Thanks to this unique music video, you can actually hear it happening.
You can see how it's moving through the atmosphere, traveling in the jet stream.
Yeah, it does sound relentless.
UW graduate student Judy Twedt is the composer of what may be the first music video of its kind. Her advisor, UW scientist Dargan Frierson, and the video team at the Department of Atmospheric Sciences were her production team. Yeah. By using sonification, the process of turning data into sound, they created this music video, the deafening rise of carbon dioxide.
Nobody hears or smells or sees carbon dioxide. We measure the concentration and then we choose how to make sense of that data. And almost always we choose to make sense of it visually. So, you know, this is just an exploration in hearing it instead of seeing it.
It was Judy's idea to use sonification to better convey the urgency of rising carbon pollution levels spewing into Earth's atmosphere, allowing viewers to not only see the data, but feel it.
When we hear sounds, we're hearing vibrations. They resonate in our bodies.
So it's no surprise that when Judy was trying to think of a more creative way to communicate the urgency of rising carbon pollution to a non-scientific community, she turned to music as her medium. The result is uniquely powerful. The Earth seemingly shouting a message. The steady, unstoppable rhythm, the rising carbon levels get increasingly higher, causing viewers' anxiety to rise along with them.
I've been really intrigued by a lot of people saying, wow, you know, I've never really thought about it that way. I've never thought about how it sounds.
And yet it ends on a hopeful note, reminding us of solutions, switching to clean energy sources, and better protecting our oceans and forests, helping Earth breathe again.
There's no single answer to this problem of global warming, but we need lots of people using their special skills and their creative energies to work on it. And so I hope that it just spurs that a little bit more.
And if words can't convince people to act quickly enough, maybe music can.